All right. I'm sorry. There wasn't enough spots for all the Bonds. That's why Lazenby's not in the intro. But in order to make it up to poor George Lazenby, here's an intro with all of him.
My name's Bond. James Bond.
Now let's get talking about the big star of this film, Diana Rigg. Okay, so I'm not even kidding. Like, it seems like that would just be a joke segue to getting into the Lazenby stuff, but no, legitimately, I love Diana Rigg in this. And so far, not only is she my favorite character in this film, she's my favorite character in the whole series. I absolutely love her. She is so damn charming and doesn't put up with Bond's shit, goes toe to toe with him several times. In the sexist era of the 60s, really having this much of a voice from a woman in this film is such a breath of fresh air. Now, yes, I guess we should talk about the other elephant in the room. So Sean Connery did not come back for this one. Instead, it was replaced by Australian actor, or well, Australian model, George Lazenby. Honestly, I went into this not wanting to see the change because I really liked Connery, but I actually really liked Lazenby, to the point that I'm pretty disappointed that he's only in just the one, because he's honestly pretty awesome, which was not something that I expected going into this, like, at all. Now, the plot of this movie is absolutely insane. So, Bond is still trying to search for Blofeld, and on his search, he comes across, it's essentially the guy who's the number two to Blofeld in like the criminal market, and this guy wants Bond to marry his daughter. Yes, that's legitimately the plot of this movie, and it's insane, and not gonna lie, I actually love it. And the whole thing is that Bond will get Blofeld's location if he marries Diana Rigg, which I should stop referring to her as Diana Rigg. Her name is Tracy in the film, or well, I guess Contessa, but they call her Tracy. I mean, yeah, it's confusing. Yeah, this film very much does not feel like the Bond films that have come before it. There's even like this falling in love montage between James Bond and Tracy, which, you've seen the other films, that's not exactly something I would expect to see. Now, despite this film being an anamorphic widescreen and trying to be a little more stylized than any other film in the series so far, it's really ugly to look at. The film is very muddied, the blacks are just way too crushing, so the darker scenes, especially that beach scene in the opening, it's really hard to get through because you just can't tell what's going on. Everything is very, very, very ugly. Which, maybe that's just my Blu-ray, but I'm pretty sure that's just how the film is. And while it seems like they're trying a little more with the action scenes, like specifically the fist fighting, they come across more like Adam West Batman fighting than actual like real cool James Bond style fighting. There's silly sound effects and over exaggerated punches. It just, I don't know, it doesn't work. Now, rather than in the last film where he was played by Donald Pleasance, in this one we got Blofeld played by Telly Savalas, and honestly, Savalas isn't very threatening as a villain. He comes across more as like an old man retiree than anything. In fact, half the time I was like, wait a minute, is Blofeld's plan really that bad? But then obviously he unveiled more and more, and so it gets worse and worse. But as is, it just seems like he's trying to make people not allergic to whatever they were allergic to. Now, I really enjoyed the stuff in the beginning with Tracy, and then once Bond is kind of off trying to do his mission, the film kind of drags until Tracy is then introduced again later in the film. But I will give it to him, the final 45 minutes is fucking phenomenal. Really, really cool. All the way from the ski chase escape, which was just awesome. Especially these two guys who are absolutely obliterated by a snow excavator. Oof, that is brutal. Then all the way to this attack on the fortress, which feels right out of the GoldenEye video game. There's even a random bobsled race between Blofeld and Bond, which this happens to Bond. But don't worry, he's up and walking literally seconds later. Yeah, the film very quickly goes from Bond chasing Blofeld to him kind of just giving up, saying he wants a brandy, and then going off and getting married to Tracy, which is very cool, just in that I wasn't expecting this film to end with a marriage. But look at how sad Moneypenny is. Oh, it's brutal. And obviously this would have been a little more effective if Sean Connery had been in the role. And I kind of kept thinking that throughout this movie of how much better it would have been if Connery was actually playing Bond, but I mean, I guess that's just how it goes. This then leads into the darkest fucking ending of all time. Why the fuck did no one warn me of this? What in the hell is wrong? Ah, come on. You're gonna create the greatest Bond girl and then you're just gonna kill her off like that?
Come on.
She even gets shot in the head. I mean, what is this? Ah, this is why we can't have nice things.
Ugh.
Bullshit. Fucking put me in a bad mood. I'm enjoying watching the Bond series and then you gotta do this to me. Come on. Come on. But I guess that's really all. On Her Majesty's Secret Service, I was not expecting to like this movie, and even after the first like 10 minutes, I was like, ooh, this is gonna be rough. But it ended up being one of my favorites, and I would put this one right along with Dr. No at 4 Bonds out of 5. This was so much better than I expected it to be, and yeah, Team Tracy for life, guys. Team Tracy for life. In the next video, we've got Sean Connery's return in
Diamonds Are Forever.
I can't wait to see the man return. I'll see you in next video. Did I say I'll see ya next video? Just pretend I said in the. Because I don't want to redo this. Yeah. Works for me too.